G'day guys, welcome to live streams for this grand final between Richmond and the Cats. Probably going to be doing half of it, and yeah, let's get started. So the national anthem is going at the moment, so it's just about to get started. You guys reckon we'll win the Cats and the Tigers? Comment down below. I reckon it'll be a wedding night, but comment down below. I'm not gonna mind for the Tigers tonight. I just want the Tigers to win. I want the Tigers to win, but at the same time, I want Geelong. So I would rather Geelong to win, and I reckon I would want Geelong to win, and I think Tigers. So. Each other. I want them to win, so yeah. So then it started. When I said it started, I probably would just made a video stream because I'm not actually doing the live stream. Let's go Geelong, let's go Geelong. I'm low it. Yeah. 1,000 people in the house that. A lot. I reckon Gary Ablett Jr. He might win the Normal Smith. Might is good. On the ground. I just want Richmond to win. But cherry white a bit later. I've got some Oreos. I've got my bottle of glasses. And I've also got my whatever it's called. It's called a yellow. I don't know what it's called, but we'll find out. Cordial, yeah, cordial. That's what it is. How do I not know cordial? Sesame. Daniel's got the oil on his legs. Will. My ball. Got the Zill ball. There you go. Oh, Martin and Sal would have got together. Oh my goodness, that would be good. Let's go, Shadows! Come on. Basha. Davies. Ball! Seriously, mate. That's not ball. I'll give you a ball, mate. Conditions as Amy said, clearing by the moment. Little knockdown by Stanley. Edwards was in there. Cotchen, soccer off the ground, hoping to get it out of the congested area. Button kept alive. Gave another 25 metres. Real intelligence.
Didn't have it!
And the cat just set the boundary.
Come on.
And happy for a boundary floating. So the two captains get an early touch. It's all about.
He didn't have that ball at all, Nick. He was holding a man, holding a man.
His nerves still not settled. So it is Nankervis and Stanley. Stanley gets a second look and then Guthrie. So Sherwood again, just bringing it forward and that one floating away.
Hey, thanks everyone.
As you can see there, Geelong will just sit one back. So we've spoken about Richmond bringing extras up to the stop.
That is a cross.
With Dusty Martin, Geelong up for they're going to sit back and try and make
I've
sure
been just doing this a bit of time. It's my, I got this heater there.
A couple back, just to the back there, Stanley. Just run through
and
there's O'Connor.
Bit across.
This
is what they do, the Tigers. They love to play on this part of the ground. They try and keep it alive.
Henry, the fast kick out. They clean
it. They said it was going to be like
to play. Getting amongst the clutch in it, as you'd expect. So Silwood. And Cooper's front spot, shallow throwing off the ground again. Silwood, gaining some meters early.
Pretend in the AFL Cup. Not like her. She's going for the wicket, isn't she? Yep.
The ball, you'll see Colin Jasny sitting on the shoulder of Martin. Strong body against another one. Stanley probably got slightly the better. Edwards was expected to land at the
end. Shot some more on there, sorry about that.
Push it forward, gets over the top. And Stanley, Henry.
Wrong guys.
Becomes such a consistent player. Mark Bittar's one of his very best. Stanley the rucker. Man Curvis there as well. Stanley in the front position. Man Curvis wins the tack. Edwards almost on the run. So we're driven forward. Pick up by Guthrie. So they go to the half four. Morgan's out to move without this occasion by Bolter. The only one out there.
They took Matthew Wall that. In the AFL, you can't get a free. He was free, huh? Coughing there before.
So each with that physicality that's been talked about all season, and a bit of last and the one before. Myers on centre wing. Taylor just had to stand up and you did pretty well, Harry.
Let's go, Geelong.
Safety.
Just feel a bit off tonight. Something left feeling. I had because I haven't did down one in like a couple of days. Just a bit of coughing back there on the floor. I haven't got a headache, it's just coughing off.
Abbott's in trouble too, by the way, guys. And he was out before he hit the ground. Gary Abbott, not happy either. Trainers running up the road. Looks to me it could be leg knee.
Oh, no.
Look at his shoulders, isn't it?
On your last dive, you get injured.
Just great. He's landed his on his shoulder. All the force of his body going through his left shoulder. So this is not good for Abbott. He's leaving the ground immediately. You could see him lift his left shoulder and his elbow.
Oh.
And immediately touched it.
That looks bad. See, I just see if I can get you guys to the screen. Guys, I'm just gonna be right back. I'm just gonna go and get something. I'll be right back.
Which is when you're coming in with a lot of plans, so you don't expect to lose someone in the first 4 or 5 minutes of the game. So how much does that upset the planning of what you want to do? You just mentioned a couple of reasons why, but how off-putting is that for a coaching staff? Well, they'll certainly have contingencies. So on the bench right now, the high performance managers will be putting some contingencies in place. They'll start to talk to the midfielders about where their rotation points will be. So rather than actually having their midfielders high, they may now put Dusty deeper if they need to get a rotation, so it becomes about man management.
With that as well, you can see Selwood, as soon as he realised that the stretcher was coming out, he's called his team in just to compose things. They know that Abbott's going off, but we spoke about Loston. Does that plan change now? Loston's so important with Grimes setting up the half back line for Richard, making sure the blokes are dropping off, the wingers are rolling back. So it's crucial for Richmond to try and find that replacement, as you said, was it? Not that it matters in grand final, but just looking at the Dangerfield 1G, I reckon if this was in a home and away game or any other game where there's a game after it, who might be in a little bit of trouble. I would suggest, let's have a look at it from this angle. I haven't seen this angle before, so there's the mop away, and bang, with forearm to the head, contact with the head. I mean, not much more he could do because his hand was sort of out ready to with the ball, but yeah, I reckon it's one of those ones where it's a natural instinct. He's punching the ball, a natural instinct is to protect yourself, and he's pulled up, and there's no way he meant to get him high. I know people look at the play, and they'll have a look at it for sure because it was an elbow to the head, but there wasn't much more he could do apart from protect himself.
Elbow to the head, someone knocked out, he would be in a bit of trouble.
I'll definitely look at it.
Yeah. So this has taken quite some time. In the meantime, Atwood's gone off the ground. And that looked, it did look bad, that shoulder, didn't it?
Was absolutely in such a... That guy started, that guy, yep. Oh, God, I don't know how he got injured about that.
Never misses, basically. He's played every game, but rarely misses. It's so integral.
He does rarely miss, Coulson.
Abbott's only a four before he ever came back. Really, I mean, he will be doing everything to get back, possibly to try and get back. I mean, we don't know the injury clearly as of yet, but we just want to...
Character off in the grand final. Wow.
Down in the rooms. Looks like he has gone. I don't know whether you can see there. I think he's gone down the rooms, Abbott, which means they're going to have a crack at it.
Situated back a little bit from the bench, guys, but as I said, he was in so much pain coming down, so you would assume that you'll take him down and assess that, and I'll come back to you with an update later in the game.
So a lot of this here is precautionary with Foston as well. This is the Ablett injury.
Oh,
he hits it. Watch his left arm and elbow, want to lift it up right there. Ouch. Tucks it in, gets it out of the way. But our medical staff with the concussion, they're currently handling with Foston in the neck brace. A lot of that is precautionary. They do a great job, and I think we're world standards as far as that goes.
And with the gas and clutch and tackle, that happens so many times. So the amount of times that you land on the ground, it's just that awful angle where you're doing.
Yeah!
So what's the process here, Bill, team for Foston?
Foston gets off.
He's going to go off. He's not coming back in the next 20 minutes. That's the rule. He'll be assessed. I doubt when we're going to see him again today, Bruce, given the severity of this and the way that he did stay down for quite a while. So he looks okay. He's taking the tape off his
face. Yeah.
But I think it looks pretty ordinary for him.
Rossi, as a coach, do you have direct communication saying
bad news for Richmond already. They've got their player out. Oh.
Based on the assessment there, and we don't know whether the actual assessment there is concussion, but if it is, which we suspect it is,
bad news for Richmond.
We'll just wait for this card to be cleared completely off the oval. Both teams one short now.
This is a weird one for the players now. They've both been pumped up, ready to go, and both teams are having a red hot crack. All of a sudden, they've had to stop for 5 minutes. You saw Sowell before. He was doing a few sprints to make sure that his legs stayed warm.
Can play, but wait and see on that. From a distance, hard to tell, but that's the word from some doctors that do this for a living back in Melbourne.
But Vossi, you were spot on. Before the injury, we had 6 minutes of play, 7 minutes of play, and there's only 2 marks. So there was a lot of missed kicks, there's a lot of just rush ons, kick off the ground, Koch and so on. You saw him just trying to take meters.
Which is not the Geelong way, is it? The lack of marks. It's not the normal Geelong way.
Just make sure. There was a switch into the middle, which Geelong liked to play that, but then it got turned over. That was just lucky that Henderson was behind the ball to get the ball back. It's very risky.
That's the only time they've had some sort of control on the game, Bruce, and that's what they will try and do. So this restart's going to be fascinating. This next minute or two, just which team might get an edge or settle slightly quicker. They've had an arm wrestle up until now, so a sensation here with Vlaston and Abbott leaving the ground.
Back in from the grand final, let's go.
So off we go again. Lambert trying to get it away.
on what Tom Walken score or Jack Rewalk will score. Come on. I get $10 from my dad if I get Hawkins or Lynch. So I get a score for 20 and then Bruce in mine, I reckon. Then we all in there. And then from the North Smith, and then for the Cats, I can buy Mars. Oh, dang if it. No, not Mars, dang if it. Yeah.
Boundary throwing, Geelong into the ground. Blitz arms, Nan Curvis knocks it forward, Cotchin there. Little handball out the back to Martin, made speed when heading towards the footy. Cotchin again, tried to get it on the ground, Selwood, bit of an arch in the back.
Push! He was like, boom! Martin! Get him! Shame that all!
Ace blocked your ace.
Yeah, that's where I just got right now. Yeah. That's better. Sorry about that, guys. Oh, come on. You know when they're pushing on the line? I think they should kind of push.
Being played the way that Richmond want to play in a rather chaotic fashion. Chris Scott looking a little frustrated there. Let's see whether they can get some clean and clear possession.
It's meant to be like, sorry, I'm going to hiccup. It's meant to be like raining, pouring.
Now Curvis. Cotchin again. Been in the thick of it, Cotchin. Trying to crash his way through on that occasion. Was so he couldn't have it and he'll get the free here. She's started well, Quincy Sullivan. He has. Look at Duncan trying to clear it along to the other side of the ground. They're all within 25 metres of him, which is not great. Need a bit more spread here.
From the Cats. Right to
Henderson.
Go to the Cats. Sir. Oh, they played the lip one up. Man, don't reckon they were sin.
Don't worry about just taking the ground. They want to go back and while the conditions aren't too bad, yes, it's a bit slippery, but there's no rain. They want to possess the ball and try and get it to the open side. Use
oh, yeah, come on, get on.
Comes back onto the bench.
10-0. 10 minutes and 38 seconds left in the first quarter.
Edwards clever. Castagna high ball. Bolton has started all right. Lynch attacked.
What, so I
got it? Okay, Minigola gets it back to Simpson. Yeah. O'Connor in very heavy traffic.
Come on, you stand on! The old man! Come on down. Yeah! I need $10 for my dad if Hawkins kicks this goal. Come on. Come on.
That's just pure relationship right there, kicks it outside him, almost is back in the
ball. He was just like, wait, just think about that, guys. He was just like,
you understood why.
Good.
So Tom Hawkins.
If he's not him do that.
Some say his best year, 35 minute kick. We'll come back a little.
Oh, come on, no! Because I've got $10 for my dad, but I did it now. This is poor. Or just keep going away. Tomorrow's video is going to be a basketball video and maybe a Fortnite video. Weekly vlogs, don't you know? But I'm doing them Wednesday and Saturday.
With the boots off, he's done for the day. What a sensational start to this grand final. Unimaginable, really. Bolton. Castagna, Guthrie, cut it off, and then Randy Gortner, check sides the ball to Grimes and Bolton, Hawkins,
oh, ball, come on!
Tries to get it to home, good stuff by the Tigers.
Little tweet, just two of the Oreos. Oh my goodness, they're not pushing me back at all. No. No, they're not. Sorry about that, guys. Come on. Hello.
Six Tigers, two cats.
It's gotta be somewhere.
Is it?
See? No, sorry, mate. Dangerfield belts forward, almost to Martin, gets a little look at it, a wrapper, broad down there.
As we close, Danger's had his stand up forwards, his turn to rotate through the middle.
So Stanley engages immediately. Finding a way, getting some space, and then that familiar hooking back, Rich made a good attempt. Views, Bolton's lively. Hits Stanley's handball, put Taylor on the pump. Richmond starting to swarm a little here. Beautiful kick.
Come on, Geelong.
Baker to McIntosh. Long and straight. And the Tigers are a really good start now.
Tigers 12.
Nice job, Keith.
Come on.
You know what else is nice? Insurance that does what you need it to do. Some only insure your house for set sum, but if anything happens, we're happy enough to repair it as it was. Don't worry, Amy has an option that does, or pays you what it would cost us to do so. Does your insurer have a complete replacement cover option? Amy does.
I'll probably just do this for a quarter time. I just probably have to get a bad turn. I just feel like filming for my guys, but yeah, I'm just gonna play a bit more cricket. And I'll probably get a boost. He's back on.
Suddenly, after that, had a couple of good minutes. Pitzar's wrapped up. Richmond getting a real taste of it. Dangerfield.
Daniel with the dirt argue. They were like, boom, 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 boom. Guffway.
Christian. Remarkable three or four seasons he's had at Richmond, Christian.
He's had three seasons at Richmond and three seasons at Gold Coast, yeah. Three seasons at Gold Coast. 13, guys. Let's go, Dylan. Let's go. Let's go, Geelong! Let's go! Let's go, Geelong! Let's go! Let's go, Geelong! Let's go!
Yes!
Let's go, Geelong! Let's go! Let's go, Geelong! Let's go! Let's go. I just said it 5 minutes.
We have all the essentials you need, including fridges, washers, kitchen appliances, laptops, home office accessories, and more. Shop online at any time. You can pick up from your local store using contactless pick and collect.
Let's go too long. We're going to be done in about 2 minutes. All right. Just too long to go.
Take advantage of contactless delivery.
Tigers, Freddy, and Long.
At Harvey Norman.
Eight for Geelong. Two goals, one, and one goal, two. After this, me and my dad are probably going to play a bit of the catching game. And I'm probably going to whistle the footy, and I'll probably go to bed after that. Sorry about that.
Still lots of time to play here, 4 minutes to play. This is going to go with a hold up nearly 30 minutes.
That's his corner. Arthur looking a little sorry as well with the hand, wrist or thumb. Hawkins again in the ruck, as Vossi pointed out before.
Preston go tweet.
Tui to stop the handball he abused.
Around
the spot. Through Pickett, and we'll have another boundary throw on deep in the counter-attack. A good miss for Geelong here.
Yeah, they've been under pressure. Keep that ball in their forward 50. They've got to be careful with Richmond. They love to rebound from their back half, so keeping it in there, put a bit of scoreboard pressure on.
See how this works out. Ball gets to central position. Couple of Tigers run into one another. Hurley doesn't get it that far. Good stuff by Short. Sword runs the gauntlet. Gets it out to Hawkins. Hawkins sprays it out to Duncan. Duncan tries to turn Martin. That's not